So the new plant can produce almost twice as much water in the same amount of time as the old plant. Wastewater from washing the filters of the old plant was approximately 150,000 cubic meters per year. The new plant will be estimated to be about 25,000 cubic meters. So that's pretty staggering. The turbidity of the old plant was a little under 0.3 on average, and this new plant will come in at around a 0.01. The chemical we use consistently with the old plant, polyaluminum chloride for coagulation, we were able to cut back considerably to only when needed, like during times of algae blooms. Water quality results will be far superior in comparison to the old plant.
Now it's over to Merlin.
My turn?
Yeah.
Your turn.
Okay.
You don't have to leave, Michelle.
You afraid of me?
Must be.
Well, I want to thank everyone who has turned out today for this opening event. I really enjoy looking at machinery like this. I have no idea what's going on in there, but it looks so exciting. I think that's where some of the purification happens.
Yes.
Yeah, I guess right. You know, we live in a country where most of us, most of the time, have the privilege of drinking pure water. Unlike so many millions of people around this globe who do not. And you know, it is thanks to the cooperation of a lot of people and a lot of entities that we are able to enjoy the security of safe and clean water for brushing your teeth, for taking your shower, or drinking. Do you drink water?
I hope you do.
Yes, the cooperation of so many people and entities. For example, it was already mentioned, the federal government and the provincial government contributed or made possible this grant from the Clean Water and Wastewater Fund for a $3.1 million structure. Federal government put in 50%, provincial government put in 33%. 17% left for the district of Chetwynd, but guess what? We have a neighbor just over the outside our border called Peace River Regional District. That 17% amounts to a little over $500,000 of actually, I think it's $532,000, of which Chetwynd had to contribute only $232,000, with the regional district contributing the additional $300,000 to make up the total price of constructing this magnificent edifice. This is more beautiful than a building downtown, isn't it? Can you imagine what's going on in there? You look at a building downtown and you can't imagine what's going on there. But here we take the water out of the river, process it here, and pump it up to your houses, where tonight some of you are going to take a shower, I'll bet that. Nobody? Yes, I think pretty well all of us are going to use this clean water today. And every time you take a sip of it, every time you, well, every time you contaminate it with whatever, coffee or cocoa, you're still using clean water, and it's not going to carry any of those sporidiums or whatever they're called.
Yes.
Right. It's going to be purified. You can be able to drink it safely. And when you drink it safely, think about the process of bringing this new plant into our hometown. You probably don't have to think about it every day, and you probably forget about it. But once in a while, think about clean water and the blessing you have of using clean water, inside and outside. I've forgotten much, but Mike, it's your turn.
Was it my turn?
Well, I don't know if I can top anything the mayor just said. Obviously, you can see his excitement
It never ceases to amaze me the excitement from a mayor on something that he has no idea about. But I mean, but it actually is important. I just want to congratulate the district of Chetwynd for really showing the leadership, and for your staff as well, for putting in the grants and doing all that hard work. So when I hear there's only a couple $100,000 from local taxpayers to have this facility, I think that's what you should really be talking about. 99% of your community will probably never be out here. They'll never see this. They take it for granted, but they expect it, as the mayor said, when you turn on your taps at home. And so just congratulations. You know, the province was able to do their small part and help, but that doesn't happen unless you do the hard work as a council and staff to make sure that the grants are applied for, that you show the leadership to make sure that this facilities like this are built. So congratulations on today.
Thank you very much. You know, thinking of the granting process, you know, writing a grant that is successful and getting $3 million out of, you know, these people in Ottawa and Victoria, they're pretty tight-fisted. And to write a grant that will squeeze out of them $3 million, that takes some thought, it takes some skill, it takes some study, it takes a lot of hours of work. And those of you in the staff and in the administration who actually put that grant together with, I don't know what part you had in it, Mike, but I'm sure...
I just bang on a few doors once you've done the hard work.
Hey, bang on those doors. Yes, it's not something that just... You know, you can't wake up in the morning and say, oh, I think I wrote a grant. There's a lot of thought, a lot of work, a lot of study that goes into that. So, I have a message here from Victoria, which I've been asked to share with you. And this is from the Honorable Selena Robinson. She's the... where are we here?
Minister of Community Sport, Cultural Development.
Okay, so Minister of Municipal Affairs?
That's the one we used to call it, yeah.
Yeah, okay. Unfortunately, she says, I am unable to be there, but I'll send you my love letter. It always feels good to celebrate important projects and advancements throughout the province. I was honored to be invited to celebrate the ribbon cutting for the water treatment plant upgrades that will benefit the district of Chetwynd. And let's not forget the people outside of town who fill up their tanks within town. Our government is committed to making investments that improve the services people rely on. Part of that commitment is making sure communities are able to maintain important infrastructure, especially systems that deliver clean and healthy drinking water. We recently signed the Investing in Canada Infrastructure Program agreement with the Government of Canada that provides access to funding for local governments and First Nations. As part of that agreement, we announced the launch and intake of the Environmental Quality Program with $243 million in available funding for projects including drinking water, wastewater, and stormwater infrastructure. These types of projects help communities build and maintain the infrastructure that people rely on while protecting our environment. We will have more to announce in the months ahead on further ways infrastructure funding from the Investing in Canada Infrastructure Program will benefit people and communities throughout BC. Selena Robertson doesn't write the next couple of words, but I am guessing that our administration here are already planning on what's going to happen next. Selena Robertson again. I would like to thank Infrastructure Canada and the District of Chetwynd, I must not forget the Regional District, Selena, who partnered with the province on this project. The water treatment plant upgrade is a great asset to the district, and will have a positive impact on the lives of the people who live there. Signed, yours with great appreciation, Selena Olson. That's the end of my agenda, and I think if I see anything, sorry?
Yeah, it's right beside you. We also would like to thank you guys very much for what we've got here. I think it's special to Chetwynd. As being some of the operators here, it's wonderful to run. It's new to us, but it's a very good piece for the town. I think it's something for the future. We're going a long ways here. Yep.
Could I say something more?
Sure.
You sure?
Yeah.
Thank you. I'm just thinking, it just occurred to me as you were saying your words, that this might make your life a little bit easier. sort of a question, but I'm surely guessing it will.
Yeah, it's one of those be careful with the answer, I think, too.
Perfect.
Okay, ready? Here we go.
Shall I do this, Justin?
Yeah.
Ready?